see what has taken place in few countries where the virus had reached earlier, and learning, taking lessons from those countries, our leaders are trying to do their best. But there are many issues which we are witnessing every day, and at present we don't know when we will reach the peak and when the decline will start. We can only hope for the best. There are many changes. Many schools like ours, we try to stay in touch with the students online. It has been challenging for the teachers, for the students, and at the same time for the parents also. Initially, we all started with the Zoom, and then the online lessons that were being conducted by the teachers, children from the lower classes till 12th were able to access. And presently, in two of the states, Karnataka and Madhya Pradesh, classes for online classes have been suspended for classes up to 5. And when we look around, we find there's a lot of disparity. This disparity is between schools which are capable of doing this, and there are many schools which are not capable of doing this. So immediate things that we are seeing, disadvantages are many. If we keep in mind the students who go to government schools, who were going there for, they were provided with free meals. So besides the loss, the academic loss, there's a large number of students in our country who are also missing out on that nutritious diet that they were having in the schools. Those are the immediate impacts. And in the longer run, I feel that even when the school reopens, maybe from September or a little later, very few parents are at present willing to send their children to the school. Other repercussions will be children who were being sent away from their homes to different places to study. Even I find that they are reluctant to go. So there will be more pressure in the school, in the places where the children are living, that we all will be facing. Since our school is located in a very remote place, it's called Singrauli district, and many students in class 11 and 12 were migrating to especially Kota. But then we all witnessed what happened in Kota, like the children got stuck up and then they had to be brought back by the various agencies and government help. So now all those children are coming back to us, and then we have problems. I think the board also has to take a note of this, and the set limit of 40 students in classes, I think this year also will have to be looked into by the board, and the number of seats have to be extended. Similarly, by maintaining social distancing in the school, whether it will be possible or not, that also we have to see when the children will come to school. We all know how full of energy they are. So schools will have to function in various shifts in order to maintain the social distancing. Of that, the role of teachers will get redefined in the present scenario also, and when the schools will open. I think the real classes will always be now complemented with online classes. Online teaching is in for staying with us. These are the things that I feel will be there for all of us to take on these challenges. Teachers who were earlier in the classroom knowledge providers, now they have to be facilitators because knowledge is already available on net. There are various teams like Microsoft team is there, so much of knowledge they have, information they have stored in their applications, which can be accessed by the students. But as a teacher, teacher's role will never go out, what I feel. As it is said, once again I'm reminded of the line from the Gurbani, it says, Kumbhe badha jal rahe, jal bin kumbh na hoi. Gyan ka badha man rahe, gur bin gyan na hoi. It means a pot is able to store the water. Kumbhe badha jal rahe. Jal kumbh mein band ke rehta hai. Aur kumbh jo hai, matka jo hai, wo paani ke bagair nahi band sakta. कुमार को पानी की जरूरत पड़ती है मटका बनाने के लिए. सिमिलरली ज्ञान का बाधा मन रहे, हमारा मन जो है वो ज्ञान उसको कंट्रोल करके रखता है और गुरु के बगैर ज्ञान प्राप्त नहीं होता. सो आई थिंक द टीचर्स रोल विल बी देयर एज अ फैसिलिटेटर एंड द टीचर्स. Computers can never replace a teacher. Someone had read it somewhere. Computers can never replace a teacher. But yes, teachers who are able to use computers will replace the teachers who are not able to. So whether they like it or not, initially during the real teaching days, there were many teachers in the school who, in spite of being motivated and encouraged, were not able to take on these smart modules as part of their teaching. But now those who will not be able to, I think they will not be able to rise well. So it's a challenge for all the teachers. Technology is in for staying with us. The sooner the teachers get on with it, the better they will be for the future. So I think this is what I have started with. I would love to listen to others. And then we will carry on.